Develop your own business today. How to fine-tune your entrepreneurship skill by Tim Guttenberg, read by Jack Campbell. Introduction. Many have the idea that to undertake is a dream to be enjoyed, to be able to get rid of a boss, and to be able to see grow and prosper their greatest professional goals in life, aiming for the longed for financial freedom and putting creative ideas into practice, and being able to have much greater earnings than if you are in a conventional job. However, for this dream to come true, it is necessary to bear in mind the series of obstacles to be faced, and so that this dream does not become a terrible nightmare, so that these difficulties can be overcome with greater ease. It is clear that it must take a lot of work, commitment, time, and investments. However, the subject constantly avoided by most beginners is the interest in understanding the minimum of finances. This is not to say that you have to become the master of finance and know every detail, even the most technical, but that you need the general and basic concepts to be able to watch your own venture with attention and knowledge. Only with this knowledge is it possible to read the main indicators that will show whether or not there is any profit in the activities performed by the company, and having a real awareness of how healthy she is and being able to discover the possible weaknesses that she may have and so can avoid losses that can easily be avoided or reduced. Chapter 1. The reasons leading to undertakes. Some of the main reasons that lead the entrepreneur to develop this financial knowledge is justified by the need to better understand his business. And there are some traditional reasons that lead to this. One of them is that the person already has a business of their own. But in general, they are always more focused on developing new ideas related to their services and products, and in turn, the financial part ends up being delegated to a third party, and the necessary analysis doesn't happen the way it should. It's done briefly and briefly, without much attention. Ironically, the best resolved companies are likely to fail just because they show flaws in finance, often high self-confidence in the enterprise, leading to focus and direct more energy in parts like marketing, product development, and innovation without any cost concerns, and short or long-term financial returns that cause serious problems for the company. And it is usually from that moment that things begin to continually slow down. Thus, this essential knowledge is necessary for the maintenance of the company's activities, regardless of its size or the complexity or not of its business. With it, it will be possible for the entrepreneur to be always aware of the real situation of his company and the viability or not of the possible choices you will make in her development. Another type of entrepreneur is still in the planning phase of the company, usually concentrates much of his energy on the idea to be elaborated and implemented the business, be it services or products, and that will be the basis of the whole company, the main activity. Given this, the entrepreneur does not spend much of his energy on finance, and in most cases, almost does not understand much of what is and what it serves. He ends up focusing on the development and implementation of the idea of the company. And because the company is small and usually the resources are already directed to areas that it thinks are most important, the financial side ends up without any specialist or finance manager. In this way, this part of the company ends up being the responsibility of either the entrepreneur himself or herself being done in a basic way or even unfortunately in a wrong way, or by someone who does it informally. This entails a darkness, because financial management is in the hands of others and is done in a basic or irregular manner. Another point that often occurs is the start of a company without the famous business plan, which will be a guide for the entrepreneur, which will give the basic directions and perspectives on investments, return, break-even point, etc. In this way, the entrepreneur can embark on an adventure that can have a terrible end because he is embarking on a journey without any direction and basic financial information, and can later become a terrible nightmare. So the book's goal is to bring the information that will make it easier to understand these concepts and their applicability in company finances. However, there are those who are aware of the need to seek knowledge of the finances of a company and understand that entrepreneurship is a way of investing, know that the traditional way of living, which would be spending years in high school, later a college in the field that will work, and consequently specializing in search of a better salary. But there are those who are looking for greater risks for higher returns, and aware of this, know.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.